Okay, here we go, the 1-2-2 forecheck. I know a couple of you have been waiting a little while for this video. I'm sorry it took so long for me to get it done, but yeah, here it is. We're going to start off showing the most aggressive style of this forecheck with the forwards up in the deepest part of the zone. And we're going to put the puck down a left-hand corner with forward 1's going to be the one pressuring them, forward 2 is going to be on the left-hand boards, and forward 3 is kind of going to be in the slot area. Defense is going to be backing up our forwards. We got D1 is going to be up on the boards, left-hand side, and D2 is going to be kind of in the left of center behind the blue line. Again, this will be just the standard formation of the most aggressive style of this forecheck. Forward 1's job is going to be to pressure the puck to force him to the boards. In this example, we're going to show him pressuring the defenseman to go all the way around the back side of the net so we can get a good idea what the movement of this forecheck is going to be in case they end up going side to side like this. Forward 3 will come over and take the boards on the right-hand side. Forward 2 will come over and take the slot area. And the defense will shift over Mirian the forward. Here's a good example of it. We get the puck, dump it into the zone, and our forecheck is already going to be set right here, as you can see, as we freeze it. You'll see that the left winger is going to be pressuring the puck. The center is going to spin out as he sees the left winger is not pressuring the player to the outside, instead he's making him go back around the boards. The right winger, he's going to go off to the boards to cut off any pass coming around the boards to the other winger. He will freeze it again right here, and you'll see that the right wing went to the board, center covering the center of the ice, and the left wing is still chasing the puck carrier around the back of the net. Now the center left wing chose to go in front of the goalie instead of going behind the net with them, and that's okay there. To do is because you can still force them back the other way, and we can just shift our positions back. And you see the if he tries to get a pass up the boards, the right winger is going to be able to cut it off right here. And if he tries to make a pass into the middle of the ice, the center will be in pretty good position to either check the guy that's receiving it or maybe pick off the pass. And we'll see what the defenseman decides to do here as we continue the play.
In the zone, 24-20, he scores! Oh, mercy!
All right, here's the positioning. Again, without all the arrows and the drawings in the way, you got forward 1 pressuring the puck, forward 3 on the boards, forward 2 in the slot, D2 on the boards behind the blue line, and D1 in the middle. If they try to make a pass up the boards, we got forward 3 right there to pick it off, and hopefully we can get a scoring chance off of that, or just cycle the puck, or just make life miserable for them after that. If they try to make a pass in the middle, you got forward 2 to pick that pass off. And if they try to pass it back behind the net to another defenseman, you got forward 1 right there blocking that pass as he's pressuring the D-man. That pretty much leaves him only with one other option, and that would be to dump the puck. And that's why we would have the defense up where they are, so they can either pick off the dump pass, or you know, just be back there to play defense and stop the breakout. If they are to get a pass through behind the net to the other defenseman, we could easily just shift over. Everybody just go back to their old position, shift over, forward 1 still pressuring the puck, forward 2 back on the left boards, forward 3 in the middle, D1 back on the boards, and D2 in the middle. If you didn't recognize the pass in time, or don't feel like you'll get there in time all the way across, it is okay to take an angled approach up to the boards or into the middle, depending on where you're at, so you can cut off the pass and create a turnover. If we're playing a team that has seen this forecheck before and is quick with their passes, where they can get a pass from behind the net away across a D-man and then a pass up the boards, what we can do is it's a little more complicated, but we can have the forward 2 come in. Since he'll be able to get there a little bit quicker than forward 1, and from his position come and pressure the puck, have D1 come down and stop the pass up the boards. Now his track won't be so straight lined as it's depicted here. It'll be more of an arcing to get to the boards faster to stop a long breakout pass. D2 would shift over and cover the long boards where D1 would have been in the old style. Forward 3 would cover where D2 was, and forward 1 would go to the slot. Again, this is more complex. This Probably won't use this until we have mastered the original. And again, we'd have to, in order for this to work, you'd have to shift these positions as soon as that pass gets off behind forward one. And then here's the positioning where everybody would be. Forward two now would be down there pressuring the puck. Forward one in the slot. D1 on the boards. D2 up on the boards behind the blue line. And forward three is now covering for the defense. Other positions this forecheck can work is like not so high, not such an aggressive forecheck. You can kind of see the forward one is pressuring them by the on the high circle. And you got forward two just below the blue line stopping the pass and forward three in the middle. And the defense, they'd be behind probably either in between the other red and blue line or you're back even further as it's not as aggressive forecheck in this situation. We can even get a less aggressive with it and just use it as a neutral zone plug. You can see the positions here. It's the same. Forward one pressuring the puck. Forward two on the boards. Forward three in the middle. And defense one and two there in our defensive zone. And there you have it, boys. That is the basic of the 1-2-2 forecheck. It's been working really well so far for us. Hopefully this video clears up some issues we may have had with it. Any questions, comments, let me know.